We just launched Fluid Compute, which takes the best parts of servers and the best parts of serverless and kind of combines them into one unified compute model. So I want to do a demo of how it works and talk about how it's both faster and more cost efficient, especially for AI applications. So let's take a look. We're going to start with this demo that we've made, and we're going to go with Fluid Compute off to start. So I'm going to send a request to this application that's going to hit a Vercel function. That Vercel function could be talking to a database, could be talking to an AI app, but it runs for about 3 seconds. So one request equaled one Vercel function. I'm going to make a few more requests, but this time I'm making a bunch of them at the same time. And we had to actually go and create 6 different functions. So horizontally, we scaled multiple functions. And the way that we kind of packed the request into a function was pretty inefficient. We only had one function that got these 2 back-to-back requests. That means for every one of those blocks, you're paying for all of that function usage. Wouldn't it be great if, let's just toggle on Fluid Compute here, when I make a request to a function, and let's say I make a bunch of requests to a function, I've got 21 here, we could send all of those requests into the same function and you would only incur that 7.9 seconds of usage. Well, that's Fluid Compute and you can enable it today. So let's show how to enable it and talk a little bit more about the model. If you're building something like an AI chatbot, this is gonna be extremely helpful for you. For example, if you're doing something simple, you know, just a small question, it doesn't take that long for the response to come back, maybe a few seconds. But as the complexity grows here, maybe you're doing something like code generation where you're streaming back entire blocks of text, this can take a pretty long time. This could be 30 seconds, it could be a couple minutes, especially if you're using a reasoning model. And that whole time in the past model, it was one request to one function, and those could be pretty long running functions. This new model allows you to pack a lot more requests into one function, which means that for AI applications and other apps that are very concurrent, that have lots of network IO, you can actually save quite a bit of usage on your Vercel functions. So if you're building an AI app, this is definitely something you're gonna wanna check out. Now, the best part about this is if you're wondering, is this gonna apply to me? Will I be able to save some usage on my Vercel functions? We've made it really easy for you to see this in our observability view. You can basically turn it on and your cost should only go down. It will never go up. So if you have a small application, for example, the best case scenario is that it stays the same. But in the worst case scenario, where maybe you have a database that times out, or you have upstream connections, where you have issues connecting to a service, in the prior model, that could turn into actually a lot of function usage while you're retrying the function over and over. This protects you against that. But in the more common case, like I'll show here, where you have actually a lot of concurrent requests coming into your application, we've seen applications save 40, 50, 60%, up to almost 85% usage on their Vercel functions, all while having, you know, really great cold start performance. In this instance, it's, you know, 0.1%, and overall better performance in terms of time to first byte and latency. So what does it actually look like to enable Fluid Compute? If you go to your project settings and then to functions, you probably notice that there's kind of a lot of stuff in here. It's honestly a little confusing. We wanted to compress all of this into great defaults to help you get great performance and have a more cost-effective model. So when you turn on Fluid Compute and you hit save, it's gonna tell you exactly what is changing. So we have a higher new function initial duration as well as the max duration. So up to 800 seconds now on paid plans, which is awesome. I'm gonna hit enable. That compresses everything into those advanced settings. And it says, hey, do you wanna redeploy? Actually, I do wanna redeploy, so I'm gonna kick that off. And it's gonna give me a toast that says, okay, I wanna view the deployment. And we get to see our new deployment kicking off with Fluid Compute enabled. So it's really that easy to get started using Fluid Compute, and I'm looking forward to you trying it out. Now, there's a few questions that I think you might have. One of them is, what does this mean for edge workers, for edge functions, this other model that we've talked about in the past? And I've tweeted about this a little bit before. Really, there's been 2 main problems. The first one is that there were a lot of things named edge, which was definitely confusing. But from our experience in talking to a lot of you all, the developer experience of using these limited edge runtimes was not great, to say the least. It was very frustrating. So over the past year, we've been building towards this fluid compute model with a number of features just iterating on the Vercel Functions model that have led us to today, where it's actually now faster for us to run all of our previous workloads that were on these edge function products on Fluid. For example, middleware will soon have support for running full Node.js, and we're actually already running all middleware on Vercel, kind of transparently under the hood, on Fluid today. So we've been testing this and making sure it's not only more stable, but faster as well. And I'm really excited about rolling this out further in a coming Next.js release. So that's Fluid Compute. I would love to hear your feedback. If you try it out, leave us a comment below. And if you want to learn more, we have a great blog post that goes in depth as well as some docs. So check it out. Try it on your projects. Let me know how much you save on your functions bill. And until then, I'll see you in the next one. Peace.